Ladies and gentlemen, I am Dr. Irina Переверзева, director of the Russian Cultural Center in Valletta, and I'd like to ask you, do you like jam? And do you think that in the past, say 2 centuries ago, people loved anything sweet more than we love now? You may ask, why I'm wondering about all that. Many years ago, I visited the State Museum of Alexander Ostrovsky, one of the greatest Russian classical playwrights. Among other items exhibited there, I discovered an old handwritten recipe book. It belonged to Ostrovsky's wife, Maria Vasilievna. A good part of it was dedicated to recipes of different jams. I immediately remembered that my grandma and a similar recipe book, as well as in my friends' families. Indeed, this phenomenon is still very much alive in modern Russia. This cultural heritage is carefully preserved in the Writer's Delight project. In Russian, it sounds like «Литературное варенье». This is a sort of cooking show with cultural and educational elements. The researchers go through family archives of the Russian writers and poets in order to find the recipes of their culinary delights and cook accordingly. For more authentic experience, the cooking is done in the country estates of Russian nobility, so-called nests of the gentry. Now many of them have been turned into literary memorial museums. The Russian Cultural Center in Valletta decided to do their own Writer's Delight project in collaboration with Mjar Local Council. Why? First of all, this locality is famous for its strawberry festival, Festa Frauli. And who among the classical Russian authors loves strawberry jam? Do you know? Ivan Turgenev is sometimes referred to as a Russian European. Brilliant novelist, he spent about one third of his life in Europe and was a good friend and a colleague of Flaubert and George Sand, Daudet, Zola, and Maupassant. Turgenev's novels and short stories were translated into many European languages and had an impact on European literature. Among a plethora of characters described by Turgenev, there is so-called Turgenev's maiden. She is a romantic and dreamy girl with a passionate soul. We in Russia still use this expression. Ivan Turgenev's favorite strawberry jam was cooked according to the recipe of his mother, Varvara Petrovna. Relations between them were, frankly speaking, far from perfect. Both were strong personalities. Varvara Petrovna, nonetheless, had a secret key to her son's heart, and that was her delicious strawberry jam. We have found out what was so special about her jam. To sweeten it, she added pieces of a sugar loaf. That's how refined sugar was produced and sold in those days. To water she added rose petals. Sounds delicious, isn't it? Turgenev's contemporaries recalled that their famous friend, who mostly lived in Europe, used to receive parcels from home and could eat a whole jar in one go.
Сейта Асира, Минновелла Талькице Пруссу, Иван Тургенев, Лельма Талампу, Миктуба Флельфт, Минмия, Себа Уэрбайн, Петроцентияй, Альмальти. Фельбиду Тависсу, Сханаты куну филь илла тахон. В даунель хиниит, бейн и новсенар утлита. Анке ликтор в нидам и фокат удечис, майку лушель хила и качья. У ликтор кельп федил, гиб да и наддав, лишь фрун талька чатур. И джефири кун им шиварайх, байны их им мамшин бедбатия, у бельсину барразеет. Упхала респоста, а чан фирта сиду и ферфер дембу бумирьяциони, ублис пресиони талимбарацаментфу уичу, и мама им шишель удзим. Экзактамент, в джорната пальдик инсертайт морт алькача. Домт не резисте тентациони, для ним течим кинфидель, манка аль момент вихет. Эль кельпциай ли мае я ад, дамы хуф флорбушелли, простес медера, макинет истен на шейн, милационе инфершатиал. Сханаса в фоканце, флахарджалитни, нибданиб за альдау кльфтит та саха ульхелит, ликин фадлильна. Бисфорцк бир кашкарца ая сашмара иста, лиль ареях нинцияй, джая фобия. Инзильт миль прочепицю, убдейт нимши, фурамаль исфар униди, лейны нишия, маруфа малинхауи колла, пала лильма талампун. Ткун хирджа, миша фиша ташмара, либель мот иль мот, инбидель фвит зар из да профонд. Ошин пассель бот, минем, ткун дихлав ди кашмара, бельхоз феррихи улаблави. Линклинационей тальвит, кину мемлия без джайер тальбалют. Хдейны нишия, эти хаддар иль хашиш. И раджа ташемш, квази ат майнису линдеуа кисха уфидзина тияу. Васальца нишия. Малат фуль хашиш, кинем сасла таль ошра таль бетула. Лихалла варайхши прошму, алузу такульхат. Шропца кеман в айт. Имтед дейт фиддель, обдейтен харес, мадвари. Неринграцияком, талатансиони, инсельмельком.
Tea parties, especially in summer, are more than just a family gathering in Russia, in the past and even today. It is a ritual when family members and their closest friends meet at the tea table for discussing news and sometimes even singing. Many classical Russian painters depicted tea parties, very popular among Russian gentry. We have organized our own tea party with Mr. Paul Bella, Mayor Omjar.
But Omjar is also famous for heritage. There are two temples, Ashrat and Svorba. Omjar is also famous for agriculture.
One of our famous products is the strawberries.
And we started organizing a feast for strawberries. We also did research to see for how many years was the strawberries grown in Malta. I think over 15th century that strawberries were grown in Malta. And Omjar we know for at least 100 years.
The Russian Cultural Center in Valletta would like to thank Mayor Vella for his kind collaboration. We are also grateful to Omjar families who invited us to their strawberry fields and showed how much time and dedicated labor it takes to grow this amazing berry.